Hey everybody, in this video we're going to be talking about bringing your props and non-human characters into Unreal Engine 4 via the Live Link plugin for iClone 7. So as you may recall, we also have the option to bring in characters. There's a connection for characters and their motions, no problem. In this version we're going to talk about animated props. They're also supported with auto setup and subsurface scattering effects. So you can see some really beautiful effects here transferring over from iClone into Unreal Engine 4. Okay, let's start off with the basics here. We have a couple of random shapes in our screen. You can see with the dodecahedron, cylinder, and so on and so forth. Let's go over to our Unreal Live Link here and make sure that we transfer all those files directly into our very basic Unreal Engine 4 project. It'll just take a moment to get those meshes over there. You can see they're transferred over, complete with mesh and skeleton. We'll talk about skeleton a little bit later. And let's activate the link over here in iClone and go over to Unreal Engine 4. And activate the link here as well. All right, so now everything's linked up. We can see everything all set up here. Let's right-click on our active camera and just go to pilot that camera. So we have consistency between our two cameras there. And you can see we have the dodecahedron, the cube. Let's go ahead and select the dodecahedron. We can move that around using the W hotkey to bring our movement gizmo up. You can press the E hotkey to use the rotation gizmo, and there we go. Everything's fine and dandy so far. However, if we select this cylinder here, let's press the W hotkey and move that around. You can see it moves around just fine. However, if we press the R hotkey, which is our scale gizmo, we're going to have a little bit of an issue. As you can see, it'll scale in iClone, but it won't scale in Unreal Engine 4. Okay, and that presents a problem. So what we need to do in this case, every modification you make for scale in iClone, you need to retransfer that object over into Unreal Engine 4. Okay, so if we select the cylinder here, let's go ahead and transfer that over again. And that'll just take a minute, and you'll see the cylinder will reappear with the new dimensions. All right, pretty cool stuff. So that's just the one little issue that you have to be aware of when you transfer props or you scale them in iClone. They won't scale in Unreal, so you have to retransfer them over. Okay, let's take a look at this non-human character now. This is, you may recognize this from iClone 7, the raptoid non-human character. So we can, if we try and scale this raptoid, look what'll happen in Unreal Engine 4. It'll kind of just burst apart like this, which you may want if it kind of looks cool. But in this case, we don't want it to burst apart like that. So again, we need to retransfer in. Just like we did with the cylinder, we need to retransfer this raptoid non-human character in. And once that's finished, the scales will be consistent between the two applications. All right, and then we can go ahead and play back. Everything will work fine and dandy. All right, so that's just be aware of that. For props as well as non-human characters, scales will may have an issue there. Okay, let's go back to frame one here. Let's take a look at the perform menu. So we're going to right-click our character, go to perform here, and just select, this option here, whatever, this walk start. And you'll see it'll transfer live over into Unreal Engine 4. No problem there. Okay, here's our jump attack. Same thing. No problem, except he jumps off the screen there. So again, we can rotate our active camera, and it'll follow suit in Unreal Engine 4 via the live link. And there you go. Looks kind of scary. With the right camera work, it could look scarier. But let's go over now to our motion key editor here, our edit motion layer tool, rather. So we're going to select edit animation layer there. And in the Edit Motion Layer tool, we can select any one of our character's bones. So the animations can transfer over. You can use iClone 7 to do all your motion key editing, and it'll transfer over live into Unreal Engine 4. iClone 7 has tons of powerful motion tools. This makes it very useful, a very useful companion with Unreal Engine 4 in terms of motion editing there. So you can see us moving around the head there, kind of rotating. And the effect is live in Unreal Engine 4 as well. Okay, so no problems there. Let's go ahead and go up to our content manager here and apply a couple of template motions as well. Just go ahead and apply this first one here. Let's go down to something cool. Here we go. So you just click and drag it onto our character in iClone. He'll stand alert and do the scream in Unreal Engine 4. So again, it's a really cool option to have to be able to transfer these motions onto your non-human characters and see the results live and beautiful over on the right-hand side in our project that we prepared for Unreal, all right? Complete with shadows and beautiful shading and everything like that. All right, in this next project, we're going to take a look at importing in an iClone origin point and using that origin point to basically move around everything that's in our iClone scene simultaneously. All right, we're going to talk about that in just a moment here. Let's go ahead and with this Unreal Engine scene here, beautiful forest scene, let's go up to our Unreal Live Link plugin option here and create Live Link origin. Okay, create an origin point. So this origin point corresponds with the world axis in iClone. So that's that little red, green, and red, blue, and green axis there, right in front of the eagle and the python over on the left there. So those two correspond to each other. Just be aware of that. Okay, let's go to our Live Link tab here. You can see we have our python and the eagle, both non-standard. So this applies to the naming convention in Unreal Engine. It doesn't apply to iClone. Just be aware of that. Okay, so the type here corresponds with Unreal Engine. Let's go ahead and deselect that camera, and we'll import in our camera and our characters, our non-human characters, and you'll see them pop up in just a moment. First, we're going to have to pilot our active camera there. Go ahead and right-click it and pilot it. And here you can see the eagle and the snake in the exact same position. If we move our camera, there you go. If I select my origin point in Unreal Engine, we can rotate that around, okay? And you can see that it'll rotate everything in the iClone scene, the eagle and the python included, all right? Just be aware of that. Let's go into game view here and just get rid of all the other non-necessary stuff here. And let's go ahead and repilot our active camera there. So let's take our eagle then, and if we want to pilot, if we want to move that eagle separately, again, it's already linked. So if we press the W hotkey, we can move it back in our scene here, way, way back onto this rock in the back here. Let's try and have it perched beautifully on this rock overlooking the ocean or whatever is in the background there. So you can see we can move it, again, using the gizmo in iClone, no problem. Let's maybe give it a little bit of a better pose here. Let's go to our scene manager, our content manager rather. You go to animations and let's give him this idle animation and just use the E hotkey to rotate him slightly. There you go. Now he's looking out reflectively upon the ocean, looking for some fish to eat or something like that. All right, pretty cool. So we can easily apply all those animations, animation templates from iClone. Let's do the same thing with the Python here. So we'll get a camera view that kind of gets them both in perspective. And I'm just going to go ahead and apply a motion for the Python there. Let's go ahead and maybe use this terrified one down here. Apply that to the Python. There we go. All right, play back. That's what Pythons do when they're scared, I guess, or terrified in this case. All right, looks pretty cool in Unreal Engine, just looping over here in iClone. And that's fine and dandy. Let's get a better perspective here with our camera. All right, there we go. And what I can do now is let's go ahead and take a look at using the Edit Motion Layer tool here to modify the animate the bones of our Python. Okay, just to demonstrate that this works as well. So we can select the neck bone there and have his head rotate around live in Unreal Engine 4. Looking not too bad. Let's go ahead and get a closer look at his jaw there. Make open the jaw, right? Pretty cool. Got a nice threatening view here. Looks like a super evil looking snake. All right, this is just to demonstrate that it works. The Edit Motion Layer tool works just fine. Okay, let's take a look at some known issues now. What I'm gonna do here is take a look at the shadow catcher in iClone, which is actually a dummy object, okay? If we go over to Unreal Live Link, it won't appear underneath the props because it's a dummy object. If we want it to appear, we can go to our Modify tab and deselect Set as Dummy. Okay, and it'll appear this big white shadow catcher on the bottom of our set there. And what I'm going to do just to switch things up is I'm going to set this box as a dummy. So we'll select the box and select Set as Dummy object. It will disappear from the props. We can go ahead and set it as dummy, deselect Set as Dummy again. Okay, let's get rid of this floor shadow light just because we don't need that light. It's just an extraneous one. And if we go back into our Unreal Live Link tab, you'll see the box and the shadow catcher are both there because they have not been set as dummies. All right, let's go ahead and transfer and import both of those in and see our project here. Let's go ahead and just activate the links on both applications. There we go. Okay, and you can see the bright shadow catcher will appear as our ground plane here. And you can see them all set, ready to go. So the cone, the cylinder, and the cube. And if we go into our RL content, you'll be able to see folders for each one of them. Okay, shadow catcher, the light and everything like that. You can see the cylinder here. Okay. The cone, they're all set and good to go. They all have their own folders with bones and meshes and everything included in there. All right. Now let's take a look at this next issue here. If I move my cylinder around, it's going to move just fine as before. Okay. What if I go ahead? What if I linked one of my objects to the other object? If I go to my modify tab here and I go to linkage and pick parent, let's link our cone to our cylinder there. And notice if I move my cylinder around now, if I select the cylinder and move it around, there's going to be a little bit of a lag in Unreal Engine 4. So just be aware of that. If you have your objects linked, there's going to be a little bit of a lag for the child objects. Okay, so you can see it sort of lagging behind about half a second. So just be aware of that. If we select the cone here and move it separately, there's no problem, just with the cone alone. And let's go over here to our content manager here in iClone. You can see all the objects, the cone. Let's go to the cone here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to unlink it, and we're going to attach the cone. So now if we attach it, we've picked the parent and picked the cylinder. Notice it's going to have a little bit of an issue in Unreal Engine 4. It's going to be the hierarchy is fine in iClone, but if we look into Unreal Engine 4, we're going to have to re-import that cylinder in. Okay, the cone goes way up there and it looks all wacky. So what we need to do is we need to select our cylinder here. Let's go ahead and just do that. Deselect all the props and the camera and the light. We don't need that stuff. Let's just select the cylinder, which is the parent object, and transfer that file in one more time. Keep in mind that in Unreal Engine, the parenting relationship is implemented by bone structure. Okay, so you'll see the bone structure here, the parenting relationship. And all props transferred into Unreal Engine 4 will be auto-skinned with a skeleton. Okay, so it'll import in just fine. Once that's finished, you can see the cylinder in the world outliner there in Unreal Engine and the cone. And now the linking is just fine. So the cone will follow the cylinder. The cone can move by itself. And we can select that other cone and just delete it. Okay, so that extraneous cone, because now the cone is part of the cylinder's hierarchy in Unreal Engine 4. Okay, and you can still move them separately. So just be aware of that. All right, you'll see the cone and cylinder as one object. And if we open up the skeleton here, you see that we have that just simple skeleton hierarchy, just the two bones there. So using Unreal Live Link to transfer all props in your scene is probably not a good idea, because there's a lot of unnecessary bone data that will be generated for these props. So just keep that in mind. This is especially true even for static props as well. And like I mentioned earlier, dummy props like the shadow catcher that are imported in become empty nodes after being transferred. So if we look at the skeletal mesh for that dummy prop there, you'll see that there's really nothing there. Just a single bone, and there's nothing really to look at. If you take a look at skeletal meshes in the Unreal Engine 4 help, and this image does look pretty old here, you can see that a skeletal mesh is made up of two parts. There's polygons that make up the surface of the skeletal mesh, and of course the hierarchy of interconnected bones, which are used to animate the object. Okay, so that bone data creates extra resources that don't need to be used in your project. If you want to minimize those, you should probably get rid of most of the bones. Static meshes are the same way. Okay, so generally, if you want to use Live Link for props, we recommend kind of minimizing the amount of props that you need to bring in via Live Link and use the FBX pipeline instead. And the reason for this, of course, is because the additional memory that it's going to take to transfer all that data over. So take this project here as an example. We have some soldiers in the foreground as well as an eye prop. They both contain animations, they both have a perform menu, and they can both utilize the motion tools in iClone. So the soldiers, for example, you'd want to keep them, import them using the Live Link method, simply because you can take advantage of all iClone's motion tools and the perform menu. The iProp as well has its own perform menus, perform motions rather, so you'd want to be able to update that live using Live Link, see the result animating in both iClone and in Unreal at the same time. However, there's things like the background items that don't really have any function other than just sitting there and looking pretty. So like the crates in the foreground there, the buildings in the background, you don't need to import those in using Live Link. And if you do, it'll just take up extra resources. So keep that in mind. Just to optimize your project, you should be able to determine which stuff you want to bring in using the Live Link plugin and which stuff you can bring in using the traditional FBX import pipeline. So that's really all I wanted to talk about today. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. Hopefully you learned a lot, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.